Please subscribe our channel Knowledge Distributor for latest technology and smartphone videos.
Of the iPhone XR even with an OLED screen, something you won't get on that newer phone. So the price point right now is not under $500, but you can find it at a good deal now versus what it was priced at last year. I gotta say, the build quality for the iPhone X has been fantastic. With the stainless steel sides, it doesn't seem like, you know, you can really beat this build quality. The iPhone XS and XS Max retain the same exact build as this phone, so that means that this one was already pretty good. So Apple decided to keep it for one more year, and there's not many phones on the market with stainless steel or feel this premium in the hand. So the iPhone X has always had that going for it, a very premium feel. Now you can see that the stainless steel on the sides, I'm not sure if it's picking it up, but they do scratch, and I did get a few scuffs here and there, and I did get a couple little tiny chips in the back glass. You can't see it on camera, but this phone has held up extremely well, and I'm super impressed with the build. After 1 year, I think it's still a really beautiful device. Okay, so quickly discussing design. When I first got this phone, I wasn't really feeling the notch right here, but I did like the overall look and feel. Is pretty premium. However, a bunch of Android manufacturers seem to have copied this and not really be original at all, which was kind of annoying. It seemed very lazy to me and very unoriginal. But the iPhone XR, XS Max, and XS now have notches, but the iPad doesn't have one. So I think we're gonna see an all screen, fully all screen eventually. Now, I never liked the camera bump on the iPhone X's design, but then it got bigger on the XS and XS Max, so now this is starting to look a little more sleek. I do like the rounded corners at the bottom of this phone. They're very comfortable, and I like the overall footprint and size of the XS Max. I think it's just a very nice size, and I did like this power button on the design for Siri and power. It's a very nice and easy to press button. So overall, I would say this design is comfortable, premium, compact, with a couple of things I would like to see, like a flat camera and just a fully all-screen design, and then it's a perfect looking phone in my opinion. Now, in terms of display, Samsung manufactured the iPhone X's display, so after 1 year, I seriously have zero problems with the display when it comes to its overall quality. It was tuned very nicely by Apple, and it's extremely sharp. So no matter what you're reading or doing on this panel, you're not going to see any pixels with this Retina, Super Retina display over here on the iPhone X. It's just a beautiful panel all around, and I really like how it comes all the way down to the edge. So there's basically no chin here for the iPhone X, which is a nice touch. Even the iPhone XR has bigger bezels than this device. So it's just a beautiful display overall. There are one or two compromises I want to mention though. Okay, so the first compromise is that when you're viewing a photo or video, the cutout right here definitely cuts into the content you are looking at, especially if you're zooming in. And if you pinch to get a full view of the video, that can be distracting for some. My second issue with this display has nothing to do with the quality. It's just that it doesn't go in landscape. And I think 5.8 inches is definitely enough space for this to flip sideways. But some people are saying it's because Apple hasn't got Face ID to work in landscape on the iPhones. I think it's going to work on the iPads that are coming up, but not on this one. So those are my only two compromises and gripes with the iPhone X's panel. That applies to the XR, XS Max, and XS as well. Okay, so discussing the software after 1 year, it's pretty easy to get used to the new introduction of gestures that came with this iPhone X, the whole new way to operate iOS, bringing the control center down. I never liked that the percentage is not able to be seen up here. That goes for the new iPhones as well. I really hope they can find a way to get the percentage up there, because it's kind of annoying that I gotta keep doing this every time. And if you've never used one of these newer iPhones, you're gonna be used to coming up from the bottom to do your control center. But I think after a couple days, you'll get used to it. iOS 12 itself is a refinement over iOS 11. And after 1 year with iOS 11, I really gotta say iOS 12 brought even better life to the iPhone X. It's super smooth, super fast. You can't notice really any difference between any iPhone that just launched and the iPhone XS, XS Max, and XR in the software department, only in the camera performance and the battery performance. The iPhone X is gonna run this software like a champ for years to come. So I have to say, there's not really a big problem with software with the iPhone X. It got even better on iOS 12. So talking a little bit about the performance on the iPhone X, it hasn't really showed any age at all. The phone is still very fast, although there's some controversy going on right now that the iPhone X has been added to the list of the battery management feature where it might throttle your phone. So if you notice any slowdown on your iPhone X, 8 or 8 Plus, make sure you go ahead and turn that off if you want to keep that peak performance. You can do that now in battery settings. The camera's fast. Everything is pretty quick. But if you're going to buy one of these secondhand, I really recommend you ask the seller, what's the battery health on that phone? Because that's important when you are buying an iPhone 10 secondhand, if you are considering that after this video. So overall performance is rocket fast on this phone, just about as fast as any of the newest iPhones, even with the 120 hertz sample rate, even on this device. Although I find the newer one just slightly faster, this one is just a hair behind. Okay, so I want to talk about the battery life just a little bit. On the iPhone 10, you can see after 1 year, I still have 100% capacity, and I've used this phone quite a bit. A lot of camera shots I've done on this phone, and you know, it's still retaining that capacity, although I do always do partial charges, so I'm never really letting it go all the way down to zero. That's probably why I still have that on my iPhone 10. But like I say, you know, I don't like how we got to pull down. We talked about that already. This phone is giving me 4.5 hours of screen time daily, sometimes over 5. Light users, it's going to easily get you through a day on the iPhone 10. The newer phones are just even better. I mean, they're like ridiculously good on battery life, especially the iPhone XS Max and XR. The XS, not that much better than this one. But this guy was never, you know, the biggest battery in a phone, but still was able to get the most out of every milliamp hour. So wasn't the battery champ that the iPhone 8 Plus was. But I think the iPhone 10 is good for a day if you're a medium to heavy user. If you're a really heavy user and you want an all day phone, this one you're going to probably have to top up around 6 p.m., 7 p.m. at nighttime. So battery life is good on here, but it's not excelling and it's not amazing battery life. It's just pretty good. So discussing audio, speakers at the bottom and speaker at the top were always very loud for me on the iPhone 10. Also, those speakers did good with speakerphone calls and voice calls. However, this didn't have a headphone jack, as if you upgraded to an iPhone 10, you probably already had one. If you came from a 6S, then you lost that here with this phone. But audio is definitely a thumbs up, and after a year, yes, the new one's got like 20 or 30% louder, but this phone was still pretty loud for its time and still not going to disappoint. So if you're thinking about buying this for audio, at least externally, it's going to be good. Bluetooth 5.0 makes Bluetooth connections rocket fast, and I think audio was pretty enjoyable on this phone, sans not having a headphone jack. So discussing the camera, you know, this camera was so good that Apple really had to outdo themselves this year to beat last year's iPhone 10. Now, the biggest differentiator between a XS, a XR, and a XS Max is the Smart HDR. You don't see it here. You only see Auto HDR. However, you know, this camera is still gonna be great for the average user, and 4K 60 is nothing to sneeze at. This thing is a beast when it comes to video. Although I am a little disappointed that they're not able to implement Smart HDR in a software update, because that is really game changing for the new cameras on a new phone. And I honestly can't go back to an iPhone 10's camera after using the XS, XS Max, and XR. But these cameras are still very good if you had anything prior to an iPhone 10. The iPhone 10, great cameras of last year. They've been improved quite a bit on the new phones. But if you have anything prior to this phone, you're going to be very impressed with the iPhone 10's camera. That's the best way I could put it. So when it comes to the phone calls, I've been pretty disappointed with a few iPhones, but the iPhone X was never one of them. Clear, loud phone calls, no drop calls really for me, maybe one in my entire year. I don't know, there wasn't a lot of them. That's all I gotta say. It's been a reliable performer in this area, and if you're buying an iPhone X now, you're gonna have no issues when it comes to its phone call reception ability for this device. It's been great for me. Okay, so in conclusion, the final verdict is in. After having this phone for 1 year, I can say that it's held up very well in terms of build quality, performance, design, everything just feels like day one. It doesn't even feel like an old phone at all, especially considering Apple kept the same design as they traditionally do with their second year after introducing a new phone. So buying this right now, I think if you can find it under $750, like under the iPhone XR price point, it definitely makes a compelling price to pick this one up at, especially if you want an OLED screen and you don't want to go $1,000 for a XS. But if you want a better camera, you want a better processor, you seriously have to consider the XR. After 1 year, I'm still very happy with the iPhone X, and I think that you will be too. But if you don't like the notch and you want the most amazing battery life on an iPhone, this one won't be it for you. If you guys found this video helpful, entertaining, informing, do me a favor, click that like button for me, and make sure you're subscribed for my upcoming comparison between the iPhone X and the iPhone XR to see which one is the better buy. I will catch you all in the next episode. Thank you very much for watching. Be sure to be well and peace.